everybody. It's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. And today we are prepping for our library garden. My husband has made me a free library. Well, it's in the progress. He's got the form built, the little house built, and now he'll be working on the doors, which he's constructing from some corrugated plastic or vinyl that we received from a building project, and he has wisely chosen to use a plastic channeling that will go on the sides.
The bottom, side, and top.
Mm-hmm. And then this will go on the side.
Except that one I chipped yesterday when I was experimenting.
Right. So it's a work in progress. And then this will be one of the doors.
Take that off once.
It will be right here.
Yeah. Put them both in once. Let's take a peek, see what it's going to look like. Have a little adapting to do on the side. Unfortunately, these didn't come in a wider width where I could have cut it down, but we'll make do with what we have.
We had to take with what we got. So these were free, so we're not finding fault with that. But we'll have one shelf for children's books and one shelf for older people,
older
adults.
People?
Adults other than children, romance and mystery and intrigue and how to do maybe some garden books.
Yeah, I like your heavy-duty hinges that you're going to have on here.
Oh, yes. No wind is going to come and take these off, that's for sure.
And if they do, I have replacements, so.
So, this is what Rick is working on today. Our son dug the hole, the post that this will set on, and then Rick's building a base on top of that post, 6x6 post, that this will sit on. And then eventually we'll have a very nice landscaped little garden area where people can walk up and look through the library, hopefully add to the library as they take one on their own, and then maybe even some little benches surrounded by flowers and bushes.
Well, what are you going to work on today?
Well, I am going to be starting to plant the garden, our vegetable garden, while Rick is rototilling and getting rid of some of the weeds and plants that we don't want over in the library garden. Our next step is going to be to create the garden area around where the library will be. So we have to take out some of the old grass roots, and if we missed any daffodils or iris that were over there presently, and then Rick's going to rototill and try to form an entryway with kind of a horseshoe shape around where the new plants will be going.
Well, we're also going to amend the soil with lots of peat moss and eventually compost, so.
Yes, that soil over there was pretty poor.
That's
the only soil we ever had added to the yard right over there. And at the time it seemed like it was fine, and for years it was fine for what we were using it. But now we're ready to move on and we want more variety of plants, and we just have to make it good so that our
cozy
will grow. Yeah, and it'll be a nice cozy little place to stop and get a book.
So if I can't find you sitting in the house, I should go out there and look for you?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, let's get pretty busy rototilling and clearing and whatever else we have to do out there.
Let's do that. Well, it's not looking too bad considering Rick has only one arm that he's rototilling with. We have a lot of things that we've taken out, and now what we're fighting is the quack grass or crab grass that was in here. You can see all those white things are the roots, and they just go on, and they keep getting tangled up in the rototiller. Now we're building up the sides and then have a straight shot in to go to the library. A little bit indented with little raised mounds on either side.
So you've got a pathway.
Yes.
So does the rototilling help?
Oh, very much so. I'm moving some of the sweet woodruff, which we like. We wanted to give everybody an update on our free library, and it stopped raining. I think we've had 3 nice days, although toward the end of the days it does rain, but it's not supposed to rain for a couple of days.
22 out of 30
days
rain in May.
Right, yep. 5 days ago was when we were planting the iris. And look at this. These iris are so strong. They are such a wonderful plant. They're even blooming after all
There's
of that.
There's another one next to it.
After all that harm we did to them. There's another one over there.
Yeah, I know. And they've got some blooming on the other side too.
I mean, they are just amazing plants. So today, we were constructing, well, I should say Rick was constructing the bench. Look at this bench. Is that a great bench or what? It's made with 4x4 posts, 4x4 supports, and then 2x6 pieces of wood for the actual bench itself. Then looking at the structure for the house itself, or the library itself, it's got a 6x6 post, 2x6s, 2 of them here, and they're going to be bolted in, and then the library will sit on top of that.
The library is 32.5 inches tall.
It'll be a great height for kids to look at the first shelf and then adults looking at the second shelf.
I meant to ask you, since you put the mulch in, sit down, how does it feel? Is that a natural?
No, it's perfect for me. Kids will love that they can paddle their feet back and forth while they read, so that's good.
Well, I have to find my big sander and put an edge on that so we don't have a sharp edge.
Mm-hmm. But those are the finishing touches.
And what
this
are you
is
doing?
The hard work.
And what are you doing on the?
I'm caulking.
You're caulking, huh?
And then I'll be painting.
And
then
we
got cedar shakes yesterday to put on the roof, which will make it look absolutely charming. So it's coming right along. I'm very excited.
Are you going to paint the bench and the house bright red?
I don't know. I haven't decided yet. The house, the library house itself, yes, will be red with probably cream trim to match our house. And then we'll see.
I think then the bench has to be red too.
It has to dry out a little though.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, even my butt now is getting kind of damp.
Now, wait a minute. Are you blaming me for that?
No, I'm just saying it has to dry a little before it gets painted.
Okay.
Our project is just coming right along. It's so exciting. It's taking shape right before our very eyes. Blood, sweat, and tears. And we've got the support done now that is so strong, you could probably put a car up here. It's very, very strong. Nothing's gonna move this. What are these, 12-inch bolts?
Yep.
12-inch bolts, recessed in the back. Very, very nicely done. All level, beautiful. And we've got the bench here. It's so comfortable. Just the right height. I still have to do some sanding on here just to make sure that there's no slivers that might get into anybody. We think we're gonna let it weather for a little bit and then make a decision about whether we paint it or not. But you have to see the house itself. Come on, follow me. Well, you just have to look at it. Yesterday, Rick did the roof. It's cedar-shaped roof that is just gonna make this the cutest little free library that I've ever seen. Just look at that, that's wonderful. So pretty. Nicely done, Richard.
Well, the only thing I thought, maybe I should have staggered them just a little bit, but oh well.
Oh well. It's a free library.
Yeah.
Now it's my duty to do some of the caulking, well, all of the caulking, just to make sure that there aren't any places that water could penetrate.
Now you're going to prime all of this, right?
Yes,
before
it's gonna
painting.
Yes, going to be primed and painted, right.
Yeah. Well, today I'm going to go see if I can find some something that I can edge this beautiful plastic. Oh my goodness, I mean, this was a great find. And again, I don't want to touch it up against that, but I do have a protective sleeve on that plastic right now, too.
And then this will peel off.
Yeah. Yep.
And it'll be just perfect. Mm-hmm.
My only concern was whether it's going to get too hot.
Yeah, I suppose. You don't want it to watertight, and yet...
Yeah, I think, you know what I may do on the sides? I may put little vents on the side at the top.
You want?
I'll drill them.
We'll have to cover them, though, so the wasps...
No, they're special vents that, you know, those little circular vents.
Okay.
Just to
keep the rain out.
Right, the rain and the bugs and so forth, to keep it cool.
Yeah, I never thought of that. It could be a little oven.
Yeah.
We could change this into an oven.
There you go.
A solar oven.
I'll rip the roof off and we'll put solar cells on top.
No, I like the roof.
Okay.
No ripping off roofs.
So what color are you going to paint it?
It's going to be red.
But you're going to leave the cedar shakes natural.
Yes, the cedar shakes will be natural, and okay. I think the inside is going to be a light coat.
Well, I also put a weather a seal on there, too.
Yes, yeah, I see that.
So,
yep, I'll just have I did my caulking here. So it should be watertight, hopefully.
Yeah. Well, I'll go to the store and see about the vents that I can get for it.
Sounds like a plan.
And I've got to do some more research on finding the edging.
Yes.
You know, that door bottom is okay, but
right.
Still not exactly what I'm looking for, so, you know.
It is the right size.
It's perfect.
Yep.
I don't particularly care for the white, but, you know, I think somebody said they had it in brown, too, I think it was Ace Hardware that I called yesterday, but I'll do some research online and see what's available. Okay, off to the store.
Go, boy, go. After a whole day of running around trying to find just the right parts, the bolts, the weather stripping for the doors, the handles, the bolts that go with the handles, the hinges we had, but we didn't have the right bolts for the hinges. Then we primed it and caulked it some more. And then Rick found vents so that we're not going to be cooking the books. They're just going to be able to breathe without any water getting in there. Obviously, they'll stay in better when we're done.
Did you just push it in a little bit, or didn't you push it in at all?
I hardly pushed it in at all.
Okay.
And now the doors will be working. They are going to be so cute. Can hardly wait. Tomorrow probably is the day that we'll be painting it the real color.
And hopefully on Sunday,
we can install it. Yep.
You have books ready?
I will be sure I do.
Yeah, well. We're going to have the children's books on the bottom because
that'll
handle up to a 13-inch height book.
Right.
And
picture
then
books.
We'll have all the paperbacks for the adults, murder mysteries and biographies and motivation.
How-to books. We stopped at a neighbor's today and she said, oh, I have all sorts of how-to books. So we may have some of those in there too.
Yeah. It'll be fun.
It will. First coat of the inside is going on. That might be all it needs because I did prime it. It's looking nice and bright. I'm very pleased. Next comes the fun part with the red.
Well, it's nice that you have this indoors today because guess what? It's raining again.
It is.
This makes what, 24?
No, we're in June.
Yeah, I know, but in the last 35 days, I think it's rained 24 times, 25 times.
Possibly. But we did have 2 days without rain.
Yeah.
I did have to water the gardens yesterday.
So if we're not out there deadheading, you know why we're not.
Or moving mulch.
Yeah.
before the red, I thought I'd do this little black trim here. But this is the underlayment for the shingles, and so there's a black ridge. So if I paint this black, it'll look perfect like little trim.
And it'll blend in with the hinges.
Yes, it'll coordinate
and
everything.
The handles.
Yes.
Are you going to do the Sistine Chapel on the inside?
No. No, I am not.
Any flowers?
Maybe.
Uh-huh. I know you already talked about you want a little window on the side with shutters and...
Mm-hmm. You just have to make it look cute.
Oh, it's not cute?
Oh, it's cute, but even cuter.
Uh-huh. So in other words, more work.
Yeah, but it's fun work.
Uh-huh. How do I get roped into these things?
If you like to.
Uh-huh.
It's about to happen. Here comes the red. Woo! Fire engine red.
Ooh, it's pretty. I hope people don't mistake this for a firebox.
It's too cute for a firebox, even though they were cute in their day.
Well, maybe you have to put a cell phone in there.
No.
Look at that precise edge.
Part.
Like painting a barn.
It is.
We could have a barn raising.
Too late. You've already done all the hard work.
Yeah, but somebody's got to lift this monster.
Yeah, I know.
How much do you think it weighs?
200 pounds.
I don't think it's quite 200. I'm guessing probably a good 70 pounds. Never expected it to weigh that much.
First coat, almost done. It's taking longer to dry because it's so damp out, but once it's dry, then I can do around places that are still wet with other colors. And then give everything another good coat. Ta-da! I'm painting again. I'm going for the second coat. I did the second coat on the black. And now I'm going for the second coat on the red. That's fun. Weather is not helping though. Thanks to the help of our sweet and strong neighbor Josh, we got it from the front porch onto its pedestal, and now it's being anchored in place.
It's just a few little things that need to be touched up, and then it looks wonderful, doesn't it?
Now that's a closed seal. It's almost like a vacuum seal. But we have a little drain table here so that if moisture does form or gets in, the books will be above the moisture line. And the top, of course, is perfect. We got the little vents in on the sides to keep the heat from building up inside in the winter, or in the summer rather.
Winter too?
Maybe.
Are you going to have it closed in wintertime?
I don't think so. I think most people read in the winter.
You're not going to close for the season?
I don't think so.
What if there's 7 feet of snow here?
Well, then I'll shovel a little path like I do for the fire hydrant.
Okay.
I'm very happy.
Well, I'm glad to hear that.
It turned out even better than I ever imagined. In they go.
First batch.
It's like giving away old friends.
Oh no, who knows what new friends will end up here.
Now there are rules that go with the free library. It's bring a book, take a book. Or I'd allow take a book and then bring a book. But it's not just taking, it's also sharing. So if a child comes and sees a book they like or two books, then the next time they come, they need to bring two books. That would be the ideal. But if somebody just really needs a book and won't ever be back or just is building their own library, I guess free library is free. So
that's right.
Hopefully we'll have people bringing some books that they've enjoyed and now want to share. That would be ideal. If you enjoyed this video watching our adventure of building our free library, please give us a thumbs up. It always helps support Wisconsin Garden video blogs by having people say they enjoyed the video. Maybe you learned something, maybe you want to put one up in your yard or encourage your neighborhood or community to do it. It seems like it's going to be a lot of fun. I hope so. We've had positive reactions so far from people we've talked to that have passed by, even the aldermen. So leave your comments, please, and tell us if you have been to a free library, any experiences you might have had. We'd love to hear your comments or your questions. And if you'd like to become part of our garden family, please subscribe. Thank you so much for walking, and if you're nearby, stop in and find a book.
For walking?
Sure. I already see some good ones in here. All right, I'm closing the door. Thanks, my honey boy, for building this for us.
Well, another thing off your to-do list, or should I say my to-do list.
Now the fun begins.
Yep.
Connect with us on YouTube.